So next, we want to see what our report looks like. But first, we want to be in runtime. You can see I'm in runtime here. And here's my runtime screen. And I've configured my simulator to simulate our color strengths as well as our mix tank level. And I've also generated some alarms. So we've got a couple of active alarms here. And if I go back to my trend window, you can see that we're generating some data here. And on the alarm screen, this is my active message list, so this will show up in the message report. And if I look at my long-term archive, this is what's going to show up in the archive report. So now that we know we have some data, let's take a look at what our report looks like. I'll go to WinCC Explorer, go to Print Jobs, right-click and do New Print Job. It's going to populate to the bottom of the list, and it's going to be named Print Job with some number. So we'll double-click that. Give it a name, and then we will select our layout, which is shift report. And then the dialog allows the user to customize the amount of data that they want in runtime before the report is run. So we'll turn that on, and then we'll just click OK. So here's our new print job. I will choose preview. And then here's our configuration dialog, and I'm going to go ahead and switch to the runtime view because if you recall, we had the hard copy object on the cover, and this is what I want to show on the cover. But if I take a look at these dynamic tables, these are my alarm logging tables, I could customize these, I could do filters, do whatever I wanted. And also on our trend control, you would be able to customize the trends as well as your time axes and things like that. So I'll set this to 1 hour. Click OK. And then we just hit Start Log. So our report previewer comes up, and we can zoom in on this, of course. You can see that we have the name of our project and the time that it was run. And if we want to look at the other pages, our active alarms, these are the alarms that we had active. These are the archived messages that we had. And then here is our trend screen, and we can zoom in on that. Now, of course, it's going to look better when you print it out on a high quality printer, but this previewer is pretty nice. And we'll just click close.